You know, we have to understand one important thing. We have to go by Finance Minister's statement, Arun Jaitley's. BJP government and Modi's government, and as a political party, we, important leaders, we have a stake in one important thing, overarching. This is Modi's government stands for corruption-free governance and corruption-free politics. That is paramount. We cannot apply these things in terms of caste, in terms of religion, in terms of these things, and very selectively, where that base is going to help us, that this base is going to help us. On these terms, if we start applying, then we will become Congress. Vote bank politics. So, and this has got a public appeal. Don't think that Modi ji is able to retain his appeal without these things. So even in Karnataka, Modi ji is a very important leader in this context. People have got faith. BJP will be able to deliver good governance in this. Who is the guarantee factor? Ultimately, people do not go into the abstracts. People, once they saw Atalji, then they saw Advani ji. You know, this go by the personalities. So today, BJP has got a very important advantage. Modi ji is seen as a person who is capable of delivering the corruption-free government. So this is in tune with what is happening in Karnataka. So the credibility of leader, the credibility of Congress, credibility of the Congress government in Karnataka, and the credibility of Shivakumar, or even in the past 2-3 leaders, if you see in a continuous this happenings, it adds a kind of credibility and halo to the Modi ji's government.
But sir, the party is led by, the state unit is led by Yediyurappa, who is going to be your chief ministerial candidate also. He has been accused of corruption. He was in jail. So how can you claim that BJP has a clean slate there?
You know, he has paid for it, for the charges. Today, court cases are not saying Yediyurappa is a convicted and all other things. In this context, BJP is always seen as a party which is interested in correcting, which is interested in balancing, which is interested in taking care of the people's interests. Yediyurappa today seen as a very powerful leader in Karnataka after taking the view of the people, supporters, leaders, everything, then only we have considered, and court cases, everything. After considering all these things, we have decided he is the man who can be the chief ministerial candidate. BJP now, after this Modi ji's government and came into existence, its appeal has further grown in Karnataka also. So anti-corruption drive, it will be seen as a commitment of the government, a central government, and definitely it is going to help in the next Karnataka elections. I say that don't underestimate the people's anger against the government. Not go by one incident nor one development. This series of issues which have come into light. So corruption is going to be the serious issue in Karnataka election, and BJP will be the gainer.
And Yediyurappa will be the leader.
Modi ji is the leader.